This is Apostle Deanna Dixon. I pray that you are having a blessed day in the Lord. If he woke you up this morning, that means that you are blessed. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah to his name. And I'm going to start off this actually live with what God had woke me up this morning. I've been up since about 4 o'clock. He told me, he said, Deanna, my people need to learn to wake up serving me, wake up worshiping me, waking up in the word. He said, my son spoke the word. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. So I want to read the word of God to you this morning. And it so happens to be actually my favorite verse out the whole Bible, in case anybody ever wanted to know, right? And I'm going to read it. Praise God. Joshua 1:8. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou should meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou should make thy way prosperous, and then thou should have good success. Well, I'm going to go ahead and dissect this. When God gave me this verse, I was a young prophet. I was about 20-something years old. And I'm telling you, he said, this is the verse. And so this is my favorite verse. I meditate on it all the time because it actually takes the whole 66 books and actually tells you what to do in what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sentences. It says, this book of the law, this is law. It's not just, some people like to just take some verses, but the whole book of God is a law. Should not depart out of our mouth. The second line, but thou should meditate. Meditate, that means we got to get in this thing day and night, that thou mayest observe. That's the only way we're going to do God's will and his work, according to all that is written. Do you remember Jesus said it 3 times? It is written. It is written. He spoke the word. Come on, somebody. Let's continue. He says, for then thou should make thy way prosperous. Don't you know that we're going to have opposition? Because notice he said make. That means something is going to try to oppose us, the enemy. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. But he said, and then thou should have good success. So if you were to look at it, these are a list of things that we must do in order to have success as being a Christian. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. You see, Jesus consumed that word. Jesus was the word. We have to start consuming the word. A lot of us, and I'm putting myself in there, a lot of us get weary and worn out because we're not speaking the word. You're speaking the situation, but you're not speaking the word of God. Every situation that Jesus encountered in the Bible, he spoke the word against the enemy. Everybody's forming their opinion. That's why, excuse me, yesterday I was talking about motivational speakers in the pulpit. I don't need your motivational speaking. Now, hold on. I'm not against anybody. Y'all need to understand that. But if you're not speaking biblical application, how can people really grow? Because a good talk, anybody could do that. I could hype y'all up. And then what? That's flesh. So I'm exciting your flesh. But the Bible says that we don't want just an excitement of the flesh. We want an internal transformation. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. To where the word of God gets inside of you. Come on, somebody. It will heal you. It will deliver you. It will free you. It will give you peace. He said, my peace that surpasses all understanding in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. That's why if the word is not being spoken in your church, biblical application, and God is not using that person to really change your life, put it this way. You're supposed to, when you go to church, if you leave the same way you came, there's something wrong. And that's just the end of the story about that. If you leave the same way you came, you did not get what you were supposed to get. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. There should be some kind of conviction, just to be real with you. And whether it's the conviction, you should be able to hear the Spirit of God saying, you know what? You got some area in your life that you need to come up. All of us do. We all have strengths and we all have weaknesses. This is what church does when he says, do not forsake the assembling of each other. And I'm going to go ahead and dissect that scripture because so many people don't know how to dissect scripture. He said, do not forsake the assembling of each other. You don't necessarily have to be in a building, because we are the church. But you do have to get together and say, you know what? I encourage my brother. I encourage my sister. You know, let's remember how they used to testify? People don't even testify in church no more. People are too busy looking to see what they could do, what they can get in church, who they can be. Y'all ain't ready for me this morning. I'm so serious. And God is tired of that. When are you going to start actually demonstrating the power of God? And excuse me, I'm a little hoarse this morning. I'm telling you, God is good. God is good. I was ministering, I think, all day yesterday. But here's the deal. A lot of churches, a lot of people are not seeing the power of God, the demonstrating power. I'm not talking about, because the Bible says that the kingdom of God is in power. It's not just in word. We can preach and teach all day long, but what have you experienced in your life? You know, I actually posed this question about maybe 2 weeks ago. Have you ever felt the Holy Ghost? And this is a personal question, and you don't have to answer it on here. That's between you and God. But have you ever really felt the Holy Ghost? Because I'm going to tell you my story again. I was under Sacramento pastor, and long story short, I was talking to him in the spirit. I know it sounds crazy, and I was saying some things I probably shouldn't have. I'm gonna be honest with you, but like, I don't know if he got no power, because he one day I feel him, next day I don't. And so I went up there. I was kind of young. I went up there and I said, well, I'm just gonna go see. And I'm telling you, he had the Holy Ghost. He had the Holy Ghost. I'm just being real, because I got laid out, honey. And hold on, it wasn't no fake falling. You know how most people fake falling. Honey, I was laid out. And so when I got up, I looked around. I said, let me get up from here. This man and laid me out. I couldn't even get up. God was like, is it real, Deanna? And that's why I asked if you ever had the Holy Ghost for real, been slain in the spirit. My legs felt like jelly. I could not get up. So I had to lay back down. That was the last time I ever did that, you know. But I wanted to know if it was real. And I found out it was real. And that's what I'm actually challenging every last one of you in the sound of my voice and those that will actually listen. Have you ever had the experience of allowing the Holy Ghost to make your whole body go limp and you feel the power of God? Because I'm going to be honest with you, and again, not to brag or boast or make anybody feel less than, here's the deal. If you have not had that happen, then that's why there's not been a real change. People are not truly being filled with God, with the Holy Spirit. You see, what's happening is they're going to church, they're worshiping God, but in flesh, when you get filled, that's a whole different story. That's why you get passionate. That's why you start living for God. It's a process. This does not happen overnight. You know, I like to be very transparent on purpose, because that's what you all need. I didn't just become this person because I wanted to, just to be honest with you. The Holy Ghost helped change me, change my talk, my walk, my actions, my thoughts. And to be honest with you, as you grow in this life, we're always forever changing. I'm afraid of people that think they've arrived. I'm afraid of people that think they're so intelligent, more intelligent than the Holy Spirit. I don't care how much education you get, PhD, DD, all that stuff. Honey, you will never outsmart the Holy Spirit. I don't care what anyone says, because the Holy Spirit is the master. Oh, you don't hear what I'm saying. Now, they're three in one, because y'all like to take people literally. What I'm saying is, when Jesus ascended, he says, I go, but I must go in order to send you help, which is the comforter. So do you understand? The Holy Ghost is supposed to be with us, be in us, guide us, stop us from doing things, stop us from saying things. And that's where the conviction come in. When you have the Holy Ghost, there's a conviction where he say, don't do that. Don't say that. Repent. You need to apologize. You know, you're wrong. Things like that. When there's no conviction, there's no indwelling of the Holy Ghost. That's why people can kill, can steal, can manipulate, can lie, even in church, because they have not been filled. So what am I saying? This is very important for you this morning. If you have not been filled with the Holy Ghost, then you are not saved for real. Come on, somebody. Because when you are saved, you are supposed to be filled with the Holy Ghost. There's supposed to be a manifestation. Now, if they're not doing altar calls anymore, I doubt if people are getting filled with the Holy Ghost. Because, and even if they're doing altar calls, I don't see too many say, well, do you want to receive the impartation of the Holy Ghost? I don't see that anymore. I don't even hear about that anymore. And that's because they can't. You can't receive anything that your pastor, preacher, teacher don't possess. Oh, come on, somebody, hallelujah. That's why I say it's a possession on both sides. Either the Holy Ghost is possessing you or a demon possessing you. But we all possess. Come on, somebody. I know you don't like that word, but it's real. Or better yet, indwelling. Maybe y'all like that, indwelling. But it's supposed to be an indwelling of the Holy Ghost. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. But how does that come about? And even after there's a filling of the Holy Ghost, you got to do what this scripture says. You got to get in this word. for day and night. I'm not talking about spending all day in the Bible, okay? I know we got duties to do and assignments to do. But you get up early in the morning. Start praising God. Start worshiping God. Let me tell you something. Our life is worship. It's not just music. See, people thinking, okay, you got to listen. No, no, no. The way you live, your lifestyle, do you really worship God? Do you really glorify God? Is there enough evidence to say that you are a Christian? Oh, come on, somebody, hallelujah. I just said something. Is there enough evidence? I mean, if you had to go into, and hold on, they're going to start bringing Christians in the synagogues when martial law come and New World Order and all this stuff. Is there enough evidence to convict you of being a Christian, a true Christian? Nah, don't fool me. And definitely don't fool yourself. Because let me tell you something. It's a warped sense of Christianhood right now. And what I mean by that is, it's not just about dressing good, smelling good, going to church and say hallelujah and act like you all that, because them demons will eat you alive, which I rebuke in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. It has to be an indwelling to where you start to get wisdom, discernment, to where you can pick up on. That's why God says, know them that labor among you. Some of you don't even know you're among warlocks and witches. And can I tell you something? Don't be surprised if warlocks and witches are running the churches and in the churches, because that's what they do. I have never had a conference where a witch didn't come or a warlock didn't come. Oh, I'm about to tell you right now. I've never had a live where a witch and a warlock didn't come. That's why I say what I say sometimes. I let them know, I know you're on here. As a matter of fact, I haven't had a class where a watch and a wall I didn't try to join. And sometimes God said, let them. I ain't scared of you. Oh, come on, somebody. I'm getting happy this morning. I feel the power of God. Like I say, it's a reason why I have the past that I have. Because I've always been strong. You know, at 12 years old, I was so strong and probably out of order. Let's just be real. But I remember my mother said something to me at 12 years old. And this is not to glorify nothing. She said, you have a lion's heart. And I didn't understand that till today. I'm walking in it. I ain't scared of nobody or nothing. And hold on. I'm not trying to say in a manner to where I'm going to disrespect or be violent. I'm saying any demon, witch, warlock, please bring it on. Because guess this is what I do. You see, God will take your past and use it, that same toughness, that same warrior spirit, and say, bring it on. I'm not scared of you. Because too many Christians scared of demons when we're supposed to look at them straight in their face and say, in the name of Jesus, what's your name? Oh, you don't hear. He said, that's what Jesus asked him. He said, who are you? He said, I am legions, for we are many. Oh, come on, somebody. I'm going somewhere with this thing. Did you not know that when you encounter a demon, you're not just encountering one. They roll in packs. Christians are the only ones that try to be a superstar. Oh, I just said something. We try to roll. We want to be the greatest. We want to be the best. And yet our enemy know that unity is power. I'm still trying to figure that one out. We all need each other. We may not like each other. And oh, I'm telling you, I'm going to get on here with a visual. I'm going to actually get on here later on today, because I got something powerful to say. Something happened powerful yesterday. I wasn't ready for it. God did not reveal that. But when it happened, I knew what time it was. And I think you guys are going to enjoy it. Some people will not, because I'm going to call some things out. You know, I'm going to say one thing right now. We have to honor who God's honor. A lot of people, you know, just because you don't like a person, or you don't even like their mandate, or you don't even like the assignment, you don't get to pick and choose. Well, why is God using them? Well, I don't understand. It's not for you to understand. Because to each people, God have called a certain prophet or a certain apostle or a certain pastor. Everybody's not going to roll with them. And that's fine, because guess what? That means that they're not part of your assignment, or you're not part of their assignment. And so I think the church has to come back to just respecting people. It's about respect. Respect the anointing on somebody's life. Respect the mandate on somebody. Don't even have to understand it. That's not your business, truth be told. That's between them and God. And if they doing something they got no business, God gonna address them, not you. Come on, somebody. I just said something. So I pray that you have had that you will have a blessed day. But you know I'm gonna get on here and say a prayer. I have to. And again, excuse me, I am hoarse. But that's what I get for shouting, and I had fun yesterday. Oh my God, the spirit was so good. Hallelujah to his name. So let me go ahead and give a prayer while you're on here, because I like to call the people that get up this early and on here the faithful few. Oh, isn't it a few? It's about 15 of y'all. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Let me tell you something. Devils don't get up this early unless to wreak havoc. Oh, come on, somebody. Because they be up now. They be up praying to their God. Don't get it twisted. But saints, with all due respect, we as a body of Christ have gotten lazy. We don't want a war no more. We don't want a hell no more. We don't want a well no more. Y'all ain't ready for me. We don't want to cause havoc. How is it that the 12 apostles, they turned this world upside down? We got 2.5 million Christians. Notice I've been saying that for a couple of days. And we can't turn this world upside down. Somebody lying. Somebody lying. All right, so let me go ahead and speak a word over your lives. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we just come to you, first of all, God, giving thanks, giving glory, giving you honor, Father God, what you deserve, for you are the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning and their end. Is there anything too hard for you, Father God? Father God, for everyone that's in the sound of my voice and those that would listen, Father God, I pray that you bestow blessings, but not just blessings, Father God, wisdom and discernment over their lives, Father God. I pray that you strengthen them in every area of their lives, Father God. They should be blessed coming in and going out. I decree and declare, Father God, if they have any sickness in their body, Father God, any disease, any things that they are struggling with, Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Father God, I pray that they are delivered, they are healed for real, Father God. Oh, Father God, I pull up that thing to the root of that thing, any spirit that is not of you, Father God. Oh, cleanse us, Father God, purify us, God, with hyssop in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father God, I pray in the name of Jesus Christ, the blood of Jesus covers them, their mind, their body, their soul in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Oh, Father God, I ask you right now, give them dunamis power, Father God, in this hour. Cover them, Father God. Sustain them, Father God. Train them, Father God, in your way, your will, your way, your work, Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Oh, Father God, I decree and declare blessings, 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 financial blessings, Father God, in their family, Father God, that their family will be saved, Father God, healed and delivered by the power of the Holy Ghost, Father God. I plead the blood of Jesus over this line. I plead the blood of Jesus over their mind. I plead the blood of Jesus, God. I stir up every gift, God. Every gift in the name of Jesus, Father God. Oh, hallelujah to your name, Father God. Oh, Father God, get them, Father God. Arrest them by the Holy Ghost, God. Let them serve you with all their might, Father God. Forgive their sins, Father God. Strengthen their hands, Father God, for war, Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We decree and declare to be so, God. Oh, use us, God. Do what you want, God. Hallelujah, God. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, God. Give him glory. Give him glory. Give him glory. Oh, Father God, we thank you, God, and we seal this prayer with the precious blood of the Lamb by saying amen, amen, amen. Go, I pray in the name of Jesus that your face shine, that his face shine upon you, Father God, in the name of Jesus. The Spirit dwell in you and around you. Witness to somebody. Touch somebody's lives today, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Use them, God. Let me tell you something. We don't have much time. Hallelujah, for the power of God. We don't have a whole lot of time like y'all think. We're supposed to be about our Father's business. Witness out there. Touch somebody. Tell the truth to your family in love. Tell the truth to your neighbor. Tell the truth to your co-worker, because you don't know when God gonna call them on. Oh, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. We don't have time to play. We don't have time to waste, saith the Lord. Hallelujah. He said, my son cometh. My son cometh. My son cometh. God bless you. God keep you. This is Apostle Deanna Dixon. Roll out, soldiers, for that is who we are. God bless.